Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Imari, also known as Soul Style Beauty, and I'm back with another video. It feels so good to be back. I want to thank you guys so much for still watching, still tuning in. And I just want to get back to like my talking videos. So basically, today I just wanted to talk about perfectionism and fruitfulness. Like, they're two different things, and like as a Christian, we can fall into this whole thing of perfectionism. I am guilty of this from time to time. I can't say that I won't fall into it like 2-3 weeks from now, like who knows. But at the same time, I feel like it's a good topic to know, and it's just something to think about. So let's talk about this topic. So I just wanted to get into like the realness, because I feel like I said, I've been a Christian for about like 4.5 years. I did not grow up Christian. I just felt like literally God called me to go to church, and like I was really at a point in my life where I was down, and I went to church, got saved, so on. But when after that moment when I got saved, I felt like the pressure was on. Like, I always had to show myself like, oh my gosh, like I can never get upset, I can never get mad, I can never show any emotions. But no, it's not like that. And God had emotions even in the Bible, and it took me some while to really like grasp that and really know that it's okay. And yes, it's true that when you are a Christian, people are looking at you, people are seeing how you are reacting to certain things, they're seeing how you live your life or whatever. And of course I feel like, okay, yes, that's great, and it's a great opportunity to minister to people through our actions. But at the same time, it doesn't mean or equate to, okay, I must put on a show and I must be perfect. And I know I fell for this. Like, in the beginning, I was just like, oh my gosh, like it's gonna be super horrible if I get upset or if I do this. But no, not true. So I want to read this verse to you. It's 1 John chapter 1 verses 8-9, and it says, if we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So what that verse means to me is like literally like recognizing God, like recognizing the sin that's within us. Because without asking for forgiveness for that sin and acknowledging it and bringing it forth to God, that doesn't give God the chance to do the inner work in us. So yeah, I think like acknowledging those things of like, yes, I did this, yes, I reacted in this way, yes, I said those wrong words, and like asking for forgiveness like shows our reverence and our respect to God almost. So I have another verse from 1 John chapter 3 verse 6, and it says, no one who abides in him keeps on sinning. No one who keeps on sinning has either seen him or known him. Like, if you're a Christian, honestly, like you are convicted, like you feel convicted, like if you are in alignment with the Spirit, you're feeling convicted about those things. Not gonna sit on the sidelines and be like, oh yes, that's great, like keep doing what you're doing. No, like he knows like our hearts, he knows that we are sinful, he knows that our flesh like is damaging like out in these streets. Perfectionism can be a way where we don't even give God the glory for certain things because we're so worried about our image, we're so worried about what other people think, we're so worried about how people view us or whatever. You finish it all, it's kind of like, okay, great, was my relationship with God really about him and letting him do the work within me, or was it just like about people pleasing and being like this, painting this perfect image for everybody? So like, if you have that whole thing of like perfectionism in your mind, like please pray to God about it. I feel that's when God can get the glory, when it's like, God, I'm really like, my temper is out of control, you need to do something about it. And like, that's when the Spirit can really move inside of you, and you know it's the work of the Holy Spirit, and you'll trust me, it's a far more everlasting change than you using your energy to sit there and put on a show. So I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video. Just burping up a storm, I can't. Ooh. But anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I'm just trying to get back to like my talks. I absolutely love my talks or whatever. And just having real conversations with you guys. So if you resonated with this topic or you felt a certain way about it, let me know down below. We can talk, we can chat. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.